This is a fire alert.
It is a remarkable sight, but it's one that has many near Ruidoso waiting in fear as flames continue to spread toward their town. Others have already seen the fire rip through their homes, 35 structures now destroyed. And Little Bear Fire has grown to more than 34,000 acres with no containment. It's an emotional time for evacuees and communities near Ruidoso who continue to wait for word whether the fire has taken their homes.
A look from Sky 7 shows some of the devastation from the air, and our crews got a rare look at one of the areas from the ground on Sunday. Action 7 News reporter Liz McKernan joins us live from the fire's base camp with how residents who were evacuated are doing tonight.
Well, guys, you just take one look around us and you can see that crews are setting up a temporary home here at the base in the field of the elementary school here in Ruidoso. And evacuees are doing the same, staying in shelters with friends or at hotels, waiting for that news if they have a home to go back to. There's a lot of looking and wondering here in Ruidoso. People flocking to public maps where they can see if their home lies within the red line, either in or out of the Little Bear Fire's destructive path.
It's scary. It's really frustrating, but we know we're not alone. It just, a lot of people are in the same boat, but not knowing whether your home is there or not, is that's frightening. They're not knowing, if you're going to have a place to go to afterwards.
Some people left home with only a few hours to pack, a not-so-simple task to choose what stays behind.
Funny thing about it, when you have to leave under a lot of pressure, I didn't think about documents. I didn't think about jewelry and things like that. I picked up a pair of pliers.
A view from Sky 7 gives us a peek at what's left inside the fire line, showing the random nature of a wildfire. In some cases, entire blocks were obliterated by this fire, but in some cases, too, you take a look over our shoulder, just a half mile away, some homes weren't even touched.
I'd like to find out what's going on, you know. They won't let you into that area yet. I was hoping the way the fire's going, there's the possibility, since it's already gone that way, it's chasing somewhere else.
A waiting game that's going to take some patience as evacuees continue to wonder if they'll have a chance to go back to a home. Now, we are told that there are infrared cameras that are going up into the air trying to map out exactly where this destruction is. However, it's going to take some time to actually get this news to folks because they're going to have crews on the ground go and assess that to make sure that the homes that are still standing, that they're giving that correct news to folks, as well as the bad news to some folks who might have lost everything. Doug and Shelley.
And do some people, are they learning just yet if their home is standing or have they not been told?
Well, Shelley, so far, some people are lucky enough to actually have others be able to see their home, whether they have friends that are firefighting on the lines or even have people that are going back to one of the areas like Rancho Ruidoso and can see from a perspective whether some of those homes are still standing. But really, as far as any sort of official word, it's very rare at this point. People, a lot of folks still just waiting and wondering when they'll be able to see their home, if they ever will again.
All right, Liz McKernan live for us tonight. Thanks for the update. There are two evacuation shelters in place tonight. In Ruidoso, it's the Ruidoso High School Gym. And in Capitan, evacuees can go to Trinity Baptist Church. Pets and livestock can be taken to J Bar J Country Church in Ruidoso or the fairgrounds in Capitan. And tonight, two community meetings for updates on the fire, both at 7 o'clock. One will be held at Ruidoso High School's main gym, the other at the fairgrounds in Capitan.